guys, Dan here. Welcome to my channel. Today I will show you how to paint Saladin for the Haki Islam army for the Infinity. We will do a lot of layers of the green here as well, and I will show you how to do his power sword. So please sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. I will start by priming our model with the red bronze spray, and after everything is dry, we'll continue by applying the first color. It will be a Steel Legion drab, so I will apply this for his cape. Put this color on the palette and add a little water to it so it flows nicely. It will take you two nice thin coats to get a nice and even coverage all around. While my previous color is drying, I will use our base color, which is a Wraithbone. And now I will go all around the model and clean up all the mess I made, all those little mistakes, because the next color that I want to use will be a contrast paint. So it's very important that you have a nice and smooth clean surface before applying the contrast paints to your model. After everything is dry, I will use a Crete Camo contrast paint. So I will use this color as my base color for both shades of green that I will do on his armor. So I will just go around and paint all his armor with this color. So you can use this color straight from the pot, no need to add anything to it, and just go around every single armor panel and do panel by panel to avoid your color to pull on the places that you actually don't want to have a shadow, like the most raised parts of his panels. Since meanwhile our first color is now completely dried up, so we will use Agrexer shade to shade it. So just be generous with this shade and then go around and cover all of his parts that we painted with the Steel Legion drag. Just be careful not to have too much pulling on the cape, but the rest of the parts of his body is completely fine, but be careful about the cape. For his face, I will use another contrast paint, a Gilliman Flash. Just a little straight from the pot, just apply all over his face. And just don't put too much. For the hilt of his blade, I will use a Black Templar. Same as before, just take it straight from the pot and just add it. Just be careful to not go on your edge of your blade. And the last contrast paint I will use today is the Saigor Brown. I will use this for his hair and his facial hairs. So just straight from the pot and apply a little all over. Try to get a nice coverage. When you are finished, just leave your model to dry, because both contrast paint and this wash will take around 20 to 30 minutes to be completely dry, so we can continue with our work after. So now it's time to start highlighting the model. So I will go back to our first color, which is a Steel Legend Drab, and now I will go all over his cape and because it became too dark, so I will brighten it up and return it to its previous state, but I will still leave the darkest recesses with the dark color from the wash. So my first highlight will be with the Zandri Dust, and I will go all around the model at the edges of his cape and these parts of his legs, and I will cover just the most raised areas, but still leave the previous color intact. So don't go too much with this color. And our last highlight will be done with the Rackard Flash. So this will be only like little touches, like little dots somewhere, little lines on the most of the folds, on the edges, just to simulate like the most extreme highlight on the model. I chose that I will use a Skrasny Green as my lighter green color, and I decided to paint his chest armor, upper arms armor and his lower legs with a brighter green, while I will paint his pants and his undershirt with a darker green color, just to create variety in his camo suit. We'll use this color to cover most of his armor plates, but leave the darkest recesses and the lower parts of the armor darker. When you are done, just add to your mix a little of Ethereal Yellow, and that will be your final highlight. So with this we will go around our model and do the line edge highlight on all the armor panels. For the darker green, I will use Dead World Forest, and I will go on the top of the previous color, like 80% of it, so I'll leave the shadows intact. Our highlight color will be a striking green. We will use this as an edge highlight as well, like to those tiny little corners on his pants and on his gloves a little. So just go around and just add like a nice little finishing touch. For the decorations on his cape, I will use Retributor Armor. So this is really precise job, so you pick up your smallest, most pointy brush and just slowly go around and just do the nice cover of these lines with your gold. If you make a little mistakes, you can always go to your Steel Legion drab and just fix it. Uh, to highlight his face, I use the Kisla Flash. So I will just highlight the most raised part of the face, like the forehead, nose, and the cheeks. For his hair, I used the Cadian Flash Tone. So you can dry brush this on his hair or do it like this as me. Remove most of the paint from your brush and just do the, with the side of your brush. Just side to side motion and try to cover most of it. For the eyes, I use the white scar and just put it in his eye sockets, and then after that I will just use any black color just to make a little dot to make his pupil. The thing is, this model has really nice sculpted eye sockets, so it is very easy to do it. And our final highlight will be to highlight his hilt of the blade and his holster for the blade. So I will use Administratum Grey just to do some edge highlighting. Nice and easy, straight job. And as well, I will highlight his gloves. Time now to do his power sword. So I will put on my palette Vague Flash, Mood Green, and Flash Gets Yellow, and I will add one drop of water to each of the colors. And now I will roughly just block it on the sword where I want my darkest color to be, my mid-tone, and my brightest color to be. And then I will start blending the colors. So I will mix on the palette like two colors next to each other, and then I will try to create a transition in between. This will be done in multiple thin coats. Only tip that I have to give you is like the color that you have on your paintbrush, you will always pull from the opposite color to the color that you have on your paintbrush, just to create a nice transition and to move the pigments toward the color that you are already painting. So wait for the color a little to dry, but not completely, so it's still a little wet, so you can work with it. And then do another thin coat, and then wait a couple of seconds, and then do another one. And you have to do it more than 10 times to get a nice transition. So this is like how it looks when it's almost done. And for the last thing, I will paint his cutting edge with the Flash Gets Yellow. And when everything is completed, I will use Ultuan Grey to do the edge highlight on the every edge of the sword. And with that, our model is completed. I will transfer him on his base that I already made. If you are interested how I did that one, I already did a video about how I make my bases on my channel. Hope this video helped you in painting your models. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And as well, leave the comment if you like to see me painting something else or show you some other technique. And please enjoy and have a nice day. Bye bye.